Malibu Dan, Malibu Dan, see the monkey take that fatty from your hand. Malibu Dan, Malibu Dan, thought you were going surfing when you jumped in that van. Now you're stoned in the sand with old Malibu Dan.
Ears loving you, buddy.
Welcome, everybody. It is Monday.
These are the Bengals at KISS FM.
Come on, Tim.
And Malibu Dan joins us on Conway. Nice to see you, dude.
Oh, it's really good to see you, cool cats. You guys look great.
Right,
good
man.
Really look good together.
Well, it's our first day back after a long vacation, a week that I will ask my partner, Tim Conway Jr.
Thank you.
Do you feel that the week went fast? To me, it went fast.
Nah, it went just right
perfect.
With me. Yeah.
Really?
I spent every day doing something different with my daughter.
Well, that's sweet.
Every day.
Just you two, the deuce.
Yeah.
I spent every day depressed out of my mind, wondering if there's any way to increase my Wellbutrin dosage.
Wow.
Yeah. You stayed around? You didn't go back, home?
I went to Vegas.
Oh, you like Vegas. I was
Aren't
in
you
Vegas.
Choking on the dosage right now?
And I take two pills. I take 450 milligrams. I take...
You have to open up a hole in your throat to get any more down there.
Right. You should really smoke weed. I mean, we've talked about it.
I take a 300 and a 150, and the doctor said, this is the max, Charlie, that you can't take any more. He called me. I said, I'm not Charlie. And he looked at my chart. He said, oh, I'm sorry, Brian. He said, you can't take more than 450. And then he said to me, and I quote, you know, you've been coming here for a year and a half. You're running around on all this medication, which made me feel like a mental patient or something. And he said, I think you need to do something in addition to the medication. I said, therapy. He said, that is exactly what I was going to suggest.
Really?
So I will be...
I would think it would be like physical activity.
No. He didn't mention that.
Rugby. Get yourself into rugby.
Yeah, he said,
like
you...
Maybe
no, cricket.
Walking.
Cricket. He said, you need to get into cricket. And I mean this weekend.
Wow.
No, he said to me, therapy. So that will start this week, where I will go for the full hour. And I'll lay there on a couch, and you know I'm going to cry like a water.
Oh, yeah.
Haven't you been to a therapist before?
Sure, of course. Absolutely.
Yeah, of course.
It didn't help, but I'll do what he says, and I'll go again, and I'll pay cash, and here we go.
Aren't you insured for that, though?
No, they don't take insurance.
Really? All right. Malibu Dan has brought up a good point here, and I'd like to ask the audience as well as Malibu Dan his opinion, because he is a connoisseur of the weed.
Yes.
Enjoys the weed.
That is correct.
When's the last time you smoked weed?
About... It's 10 o'clock, got home at 6:30.
How many bowls did you have? You have a big bowl? Bong?
Actually, I shared
bong,
a...
I shared a...
What was that?
A bowl or a bong,
a
joint?
I give my wife the option to have either a daddy roller or a joint, take a nice bong, or a pipe.
You refer to yourself as daddy to your wife? You call yourself daddy?
Yeah, dude, she's a dirty whore. She likes it.
Yeah. Come here, let me spank you, you bitch.
Daddy's home, dear.
I get away with this because she's not listening.
All right, so you smoked weed with your wife.
Yeah, she preferred the joint, so I rolled us a nice joint.
So are you high now? Are you high right
I'm
now?
I'm not. I ate, and that soaked up a little bit of the deal, and it's been 4 hours. So I'm due for another one.
Yeah, you do now.
Yeah.
All right. Sure. I got to ask you a question, young man. A lot of people go into this holiday season regretting it because they always suffer through depression.
That's me.
During the holidays.
Which is sad, by the way. That's never fun.
The king of the big D is sitting on my left.
Well, I prefer the term dean. I am the dean of depression.
The dean of depression is sitting here. Does pot help you through the holiday depression?
That's actually a great question, Tim.
Does it?
Does pot help you with the holiday depression? I'm good looking. Call me. Right?
Have Sam Rubin set up that whole entire topic with phone.
I don't know if I can actually remember the question.
You remember the phone
numbers. Yeah.
The question
Do you want me
to
write the question down?
I might need assistance.
Does pot help you through holiday depression?
Does pot help you through holiday depression? Okay, let's see if I could do my best Sam Rubin impression.
I'll do that. And now, here's Sam Rubin.
Thanks so much, Brian. I'm very good looking. I'm rich. I go to Susan's Healthy Gourmet to maintain this beautiful body of mine. Many of you aren't as fortunate as me. So I want to know, for all those who aren't as lucky as I am, does pot help you through the holidays with your depression? Give me a call now and tell me how wonderful I am. 520-9710. 520-90. Remember, you would scream out the numbers? Like, everything was very monotone somewhat. And
I want to come out right now.
Oh. I am a little sour at Sam.
Oh, Sammy, man.
What?
Well, I am. No, why? Because my lovely wife did her big whore fest deal. And I can't blame him, but he just didn't.
Your wife is still doing the whore fest?
The horror fest. Horror fest. The eight films to die for.
No, I misunderstood. I'm sorry. I think some of the audience may be misunderstood.
Horror fest. Horror fest.
All right.
Right? So anyway, you know, they were on Good Day LA. They were on some big stuff. And I said, what?
The Shecky Green is the deuce. It's Laurel and Hardy over here.
You know, Tim.
Horror fest. It's horror fest. Horror fest. Your wife's still doing that horror fest. It's horror fest.
That was so weird. And his wife is still doing the horror fest. And it's horror fest or horror
vaudeville.
Fest.
Excuse me, Dan. Bad vaudeville.
Dan, can you give me a moment? Just a moment.
Yeah, sure.
Tim.
Yes, sir.
There have been times
I know
when you
I bombed
when you have thrown out sub A
I
material.
I understand,
and
but I don't beat it in the ground like that, like the two of yous.
Horror fest.
The show of shows, everybody. Horror fest.
Well, the Moonlight has his wife, and she's doing the horror fest, and he said horror fest, and he said no horror, and he said horror, can't no horror.
Anyway.
But I don't attack you on the air when you bomb, my friend, and that is
no,
the
that's
difference.
Not true.
That is true. Dan, you were saying?
Oh, it's like it's an old, you know, like a Milton Berle fest in here.
You know, you guys should be banging.
Horror fest.
You guys should be
horror fest. It's a horror. Is that an H or a W there?
Anyway, look, I just was bummed out because I called him.
There he goes.
Oh, there he goes. Brian, come on.
I'm not going to take it.
Just sit down. I'm here. I'm
all right, let him go. He's got
to
cool off. All right.
I'll be back. I'm not going to goddamn take it.
All right. Horror fest or horror fest?
You know, I'm a little.
Yeah, your wife, is she a whore? Horror.
You're not worried about your boy?
No, he's fine. But honestly, God, I mean, with the two of you, it's...
Well, look, no, come on, I can't defend myself.
It's like, who cares?
No, you're right, you're right. I actually repeated, in my defense, I repeated it back to him. And then he came back to me.
All right.
And I repeated back to him. Anyway, whatever, dude.
Horror.
So anyway, I'm bummed out at Sam. We've known him for how long?
Roast in here. It's like a really bad roast.
Well, it's hot in here.
Ugh.
It's really hot in here. And you two, you fight all
hot
the time.
Hot as a roast in here?
No!
Ugh.
What are you going to do with him?
It's like 1928 in here. With the
Can I ask you, did you ever...
Hot as a roast in here. A horror roast. A horror roast.
Did you ever stop him from leaving? Ever? No. He's always just left.
Bingo. All right, what do you got?
Hey, I got a question
for you. Your wife's in the horror fest.
No, forget about that. It's no big deal.
I know.
But listen, I got a question for you. What is your biggest pet peeve, just in general? I know it sounds like...
Are you two?
Well, let me tell you why. Can I please explain to you...
My biggest what?
Pet peeve. Let me tell you why. Okay?
Oh, baboo.
I got into the car on the way over here. And I noticed that.
You know what my biggest pet peeve is?
What?
37-year-olds who don't know simple terms.
35. And what are you talking about?
All right.
Can I please tell you why?
It's irritating.
Can I please tell you why I bring this up?
Right.
I'm on my way over here, and my wife's got the heat on in the car, but the air conditioning.
Oh, that's a pet peeve?
Right. And the air conditioning button is on?
Right.
So my question is. Why would that not irritate me? Why is that? That would be.
What?
You know what? It's about time you got
back.
That would be
a what?
A pet peeve.
I heard that in the hallway, and I had to come back in.
What's wrong with you guys? First of all, you guys are both venting your tension out on me,
Babu.
And it's really between you two.
Babu, that's not true. It's not the term. It's wildly mispronounced.
Try it again, Dan.
Well, obviously I'm messing it up. I'm not sure exactly what I'm doing wrong. But do you see what I mean? But did I at least get the analogy correct? How that could be the irritating?
Whoa.
Look out.
Danger. All right, so what other pet peeves do you have?
Well, you know what? I'm glad that's not a bad question. First of all, my wife turning on the heat in the car and putting the air conditioning on.
That's one of your majors.
I'm very upset about that. The other thing I don't like is when we used to work in Koreatown, when the Koreans used to stop in the middle of the road and let their, you know, passenger out without getting out of the way.
Excuse me. I think that is probably a generalization about a racial group.
I think he's got something there. I understand. Anybody who does that is a pain in the ass.
I do have a couple, but I can't exactly remember what they were.
A couple what?
Pet peeves. But I can't remember exactly what they are at this time. I'll remember and I'll try to write them down.
I'm not even going to help you. All right, let's...
I'm a little lost at what the problem is.
Right.
The term is not pet peeve. That's the problem.
That's what you're irritated about?
That's not the term.
No, I irritated him before you got here.
I know. I heard. We all heard. You seem to have irritated a lot of
people. I don't know how you go 35 years and hear every time that term is used, you hear it differently than what people say it.
Frankly, I don't actually hear it often.
Frankly, my dear.
Jesus Christ.
Frankly, Tim.
Frankly, Junior, if you must know.
He throws a frankly at
my
you.
My God. Don't make me throw a frankly at you.
It's not pet pee.
Well, if there's more than one thing that irritates you, it's pet peeves.
So do you have a lot of pet peeves?
I think we all have. We all have issues.
Oh, man. People listen to you talk and they go, wow, I'm Einstein, man. I'm effing Einstein, man.
I tell you, man. They hear you, it's man. Always... And they think, God damn it, man. I tell you, I am effing Albert, effing Einstein, man. I got to be
honest. Especially people who are on pot. They're like, wow, I'm really smart. Oh,
Danny, man. Danny, Babo.
Don't you think at least you can make somewhat of an agreeing comment to what me going?
Hey, man, look, I got to be honest with you, dude. There's a lot of goddamn guys, man.
Hey, when you're mad at somebody, are you peed at them?
I don't know. Upset at them? Yeah, I'm upset.
You're peed.
Pissed?
No, peed.
I don't think I've heard that term. Like, man, I'm so peed at you. Is that what you're talking about?
You pick a caller, and they'll correct the term for you.
All right.
Any of those callers.
I'll pick line 51.
All right. All right. Is this Krista?
Yeah, this is Krista.
Hey, Krista.
Okay. The term is not pet peeve. What is it?
The term pet peeve?
There you go.
P-E-E-V-E? Is that what P-E-E-V? Pet peeve.
P-E-E-V-E.
And what was I saying?
P. You were saying P. Yeah, it's P-E-E-V-E.
I think we all learned something tonight now, didn't we? Didn't we all learn something tonight?
No, Krista didn't. Nano didn't. Evan didn't. John didn't. Gina, Jerry, John, Randy. Nobody. You did.
Krista, what do your breasts look like?
My husband's on the phone.
Oh,
really?
All right,
really?
Let's talk to this young lady. Can marijuana get you through holiday depression?
Okay, well, I want my husband to answer this because he's the one who smokes.
All right.
Is your husband here?
Put him on.
Yeah, Chuck's on. Here, hold on.
All right.
On the phone,
all right,
okay?
Hello, Chuck.
Hey, Chuck.
Is that Wild?
Hey, what's going on?
Hey, dude.
Chuck, so? Bobuck. FIFA. You like that, Tim? I played the name game with Chuck.
Yes, you did. All right.
What's up, Chuck?
Maybe you can answer the question better than I could.
Well, I don't smoke weed, so I can't tell you yes or no, but Malibu Dan does. But Malibu Dan smokes too regularly to be...
Well, you don't have to smoke it. You can eat it also.
Well, all right. Whatever the case is, Chuck. But if you smoke pot all year round, then it doesn't matter during the holidays if you smoke it. You're like, but I'm talking about people who smoke it just to get through the holiday depression. Does that help?
Are you suggesting, Tim, Chuck, hold your answer.
I'm suggesting that you might investigate this.
Really? Between now and...
Well, that's why we're going to take some calls on it.
Yeah, because to be completely candid with you...
You're not going to smoke?
No, honest to God. If I could wake up tomorrow morning,
yeah,
and it could be January 2nd,
you would do it.
I would be thrilled.
But the holidays are the best time of year, man.
They are the worst time of year.
But why? You worry me.
Yeah, they are depressing for a lot of people. All right, Isaac in Inglewood, you're on 97.1 Free FM.
Hey, what's up, Conway and Whitman?
Hey,
how you guys doing?
All right, now, are you a regular pot smoker?
Oh, yeah, definitely, man.
Not this guy.
Nah, dude, you don't sound like it. You run like a Fortune 500 company, right?
Nah, man, I don't.
You're just BSing everybody. Try that cool.
Yeah.
You run like... You start Google?
Nah, man.
Would you start?
Pot just gets me through the whole year, you know.
You're an international export or import or something.
Nah, man.
You're like an oil tycoon.
Nah, I'm just a regular blue-collar
guy. Nah, dude, you probably own half of downtown.
Oh, that's right. I bet you're a real estate developer, Isaac.
Yeah, dude, get out of here. Dude, you don't know anything about pot. I can't stand it when these wealthy guys call up.
I know. Well, they try to pretend. Well, they want to get on the air.
They want to act cool.
Right.
They want to get chicks. So they tell everybody they smoke weed.
That's exactly right.
Guy probably owns, 7,000 apartment buildings.
Can I tell you about the marijuana? I didn't bring this up with my psychiatrist when I was at the office.
So you saw him already?
No, I see him regularly.
Oh.
Yeah, I'm on medication.
One sec. The question of the audience is... Will pot help Brian Whitman get through his holiday depression? Now Brian is not a pot smoker by nature.
I've never smoked pot.
Never smoked pot.
Right.
So I'd like to take some calls from people who don't smoke pot all year, but you smoke it just through the holidays to get through that depression. Does that work for you?
Hit him with the numbers, Tim.
All right. Gina, do me a favor. If you could ask some of these idiots if they smoke pot all year round and then maybe let them go... take a bowl or something. I'd like to talk to people who don't smoke 10 or 11 months a year, but just smoke around the holidays to get through the depression.
Right. I think it's a very fair question. Hit him with those numbers, Tim.
520-9710 and 888-520-9710.
Here's what happened at the psychiatrist's office.
I think it would do wonders for you.
Thank you. I said to my doctor, my depression is escalating. He said, why?
We need to go to break!
May I tell the story?
It sounds like a break's coming up.
That's really rude. That's really, really rude.
We need to go to break!
All right, all right. Can you yell at us, you a-hole? All right, go ahead, Brent.
By the way, retard in there, I would have played some Christmas music under this conversation.
Mm. Yeah,
if I were behind the board, but I'm only one man. Tim. I said to the doctor, my depression is escalating. He said, why? I said, well, it's the holiday times. I mean, you know, I have a very difficult time with Christmas, and I always have. I mean, you know. And he said to me, why? Why do the holidays depress you? I said, well, doctor, it's the expectation of joy and happiness that everybody has of you. And he said, Brian, and he took his glasses off. And he said, you put that on yourself. Nobody's putting that on you. Nobody's putting the expectation of joy and happiness upon you.
Can you turn this up? This is great.
You're thrusting that on yourself. And then he said, that's $120. I don't take insurance or credit cards.
Well, he doesn't take credit cards?
Does he not really take credit cards?
He takes credit cards. But he said, I don't take insurance and our time's up, so please get out. So that's the last interaction I had with the doctor.
It's Conway and Whitman live on 97.1 Free FM. Malibu Dan joins us. If you smoke pot just for the holidays, does that enhance the season for you and alleviate some of the depression? 520-9710 and 888-520-9710. It's Conway and Whitman live on 97.1 Free FM.
We need to go to break!